Here's a cool way, if you ever do textures in Blender and you have like multiple textures layered. For example, on this one, I have multiple layers right here. Where is it? Right here. So I have normal body and then I have some shadow map and light map. Actually, this doesn't really have a lot. Let's check another one. Clothes. Oh yeah, there you go. So there's not a lot, but they have normal map, light map, and then shadow map, right? Like I have like a bunch of sims here. So the problem is like sometimes when you use Blender and then you take this into another software and try to turn it into one software, like layer it on top of each other, right? Or combine it. Problem is like different softwares do it differently, right? Whether it comes to like multiply or additive or whatever it is. So here's a cool and easy way to do it in Blender without needing to use any other software, right? So you create a plane here. You create a plane. Sorry, here you create a plane. Move it on the side. And then increase it by 3 times. So S, 3, enter. So the scale of this should be like on 3, right? And then we're gonna center it, our cursor to a plane center. So cursor to selected. And then we're gonna create a camera here. Just like that. Just move it in front of it. Reset. And then just aim it at the plane itself, right? You reset it by Alt-R. And then I press R, X, and 90, right? I should probably have the screencast on for this. There you go. I'm going to say it again. So we center the camera first. Then we R, X, 90. Right? So it's looking at the camera. Then the camera itself, we can increase the resolution on this because my textures are 4K in this case. And in the render, or not in the render, the camera option or the data, we change perspective to orthographic and we don't touch it. That's it. Then I'm gonna go on the plane. I'm gonna change its material to whatever I want. In this case, let's do body, for example, right? So this is all layers being merged already, right? Because this is exactly what I have on the model right here, right? Because I can show this like being unmerged. For example, if I go in textures, right? And I switch to this mode, like you can see that these are all different layers, right? This one, and this one, right? But if I press this, this is gonna show me all the layers together. A good example again would be if I do it on clothing. There we go. So we have different layers. This one, and this one. Right, you can see the lines on this one. You don't have the lines, but then in this mode you have like viewport shading, like these two viewport shading modes. This one shows you like each layer and this one shows you like all of them combined. So what our camera is gonna do right now, I'm gonna press F12 and it's basically gonna render the whole texture being merged on top of each other basically, right? So instead of like taking all these textures into other software and then trying to do it there, I basically do it here, just like this. So if you want to see how the camera looks like right now, this is what camera sees, you see? So by increasing the plane size by 3 specifically, and then camera being centered, right? It basically is ideally centered around this texture. This never failed me. It always works. And you don't have to go in other software. Basically, it's also very cool if you're trying to add some sort of like changes, like color changes to your mesh or to your textures. So I just added hue, right? So if I want to change hue of this real quick, I can just add that and then change it, right? And if I just render it, I'm gonna have a texture with fully changed textures basically, right? And you can use this in like many, many different ways. So it's like a very cool way of doing it. Like you can see the textures actually changed on the character itself, right? So yeah. So it's a very cool way of doing that. I'll delete that. So again, I'm gonna just F12. I have this, and then all I do is I just press F3 to save it, and I specifically save it at 16-bit. This one is clothes, right? So I'm gonna do clothes. And usually I mark my layered textures with F at the end. So it's like finished basically, but you can mark it with whatever you want. And then I save it. And that's it. It's gonna be in my folder. Right here. So yeah, there you go. So all of them are layered on top of it, or all of them are combined, like all the stitches and all the lights that I had. So all of them are just combined now in one texture. But yeah, it's a cool way of doing this without needing to use other softwares, basically. All right, so that's our clothes. Let's do body. It's also 4K. Body. How do you go about maintaining proper quad topology on your character? Good question, but I just don't know how to answer you. I'm a little bit autistic and I like when everything is done in a neat manner. So it just kind of sort of comes naturally. The fact of me wanting things to look and be in a neat manner, I guess. Also, obviously a lot of experience. Kind of words around each loop to make sure it's about 8 or 10 or 12. Yeah, I don't do that. Problem is, I see what you're doing, and I would not actually. I guess like if you're at the start of like if you're a beginner more or less at doing this type of stuff, I would say that that can definitely be beneficial because you're trying to keep like a certain like you're trying to keep yourself within certain limits, which is not bad. It's gonna definitely teach you how to make proper models, right? But you are at the beginning level of like learning, right? And like I am way past that. The way I go around making things, as far as like loop cuts and stuff like that goes, it's just a lot more natural to me in terms of like whenever I make something, right? And I have like certain shapes happening and certain like topology happening, I more so go by feel rather than some sort of like a taught manner of doing things, right? Like you probably watched a bunch of videos and they told you like, oh, have like this many loops or have this many vertices around here, so have this many vertices around here, right? I go by experience, I guess, right? So whenever I'm making like eyes, for example, or the eye sockets, I don't count specific amount. I more so go by like this corner probably needs this much, this area, this distance, and so on, basically, right? So I have like some general ideas, but then I also have like just purely from experience. So I don't necessarily count. For example, if I take couple vert, actually let me do it in this software because I, yeah, I think. So whenever I'm like making eyes, right, like I do know that I need a vertice around here because it's gonna be connecting later on to the nose, right? So I always have vertice here, right? I also, and after that I understand that like this can be like too quadratic, right? So I start doing stuff like this, right? For example, right? I also know that this has to be like a little bit more, has to have like a little bit more sharper edge. So I tend to like have a little bit more vertices here. Then I do this. Same thing here, right? And then I connect it, right? So I usually have it around like something like this. So I don't have like a set amount. Rather, I do it based on what I need to do or based on what I have in front of me, basically. So it's like a lot more fluid, right? So in this case, I need something like this, so I do something like this. But I do have, like I said, like a couple things in mind, which is, for example, having like vertices that I will later on connect like this, right? Even this sometimes. Actually, maybe not. How would I go about connecting this, actually? Actually, I know how I would go about this. I would go like this later on. And then this would probably connect here on the head. And then I would have something like this. And I would connect it like that. And then I would go around connecting it upwards, basically, like that, right? So I still have quads here, technically speaking, right? And then so on and so on, right? Where it's supposed to connect. Yeah, so like I don't have like a set way of doing things. I know a lot of tutorials tend to show this type of modeling in a way where it's always like a set way of doing things, but I don't do it that way because first of all, you're limiting yourself like way too fucking much to only a certain way of doing things. And whenever you are limiting yourself to only be doing various parts of modeling only in a certain way, right? That's almost never good, right? You're gonna be stuck with like a certain style that's just probably poor because it's for beginners to begin with, right? Like you don't want to be stuck with modeling that's meant for beginners. You want to go like well beyond that, right? And for you to go well beyond that, you have to build yourself some sort of base that will allow you to do that, right? In this case, it would be not confining yourself within certain limits of modeling, right? Like go beyond it, figure out like how it works for you, right? Be a lot more fluid with your modeling rather than like being confined with numbers or whatever it is, right? Oh, like you have to have like this amount of loops. No, don't do that. Do whatever works better, you know? And the more models that you do, the more mistakes you do, the more you will understand, like, how can you make things better, right? That's another problem I feel like a lot of people have. Like, before actually doing anything, they start asking. Don't ask. You're not gonna learn anything from that. Well, you are gonna learn something from asking, but, like, 90% of the knowledge that you're gonna get is from you yourself making mistakes. Like, you have to understand that your first ever, whatever you do, is not gonna be the greatest thing ever. It's gonna be the 100th. Like, the 100th model that you're gonna do, that's gonna be great. So, don't look for like, in a month I'm gonna be doing be great. No. Like, be like, in a year I'm gonna be great. I tried to follow your head tutorial, but kind of tried. You would do that. As a beginner, you would obviously do that because it's not aimed at specifically showing you a very particular way of doing something, right? I even talked through the video that, like, I'm gonna go a little bit more fluid about this, right? Because as I model, I'm gonna change a lot of things, right? It's not like, because, like, there are tutorials where, for example, they start from, like, hey guys, so we're gonna do a head tutorial and then take a cube, right? So we're gonna take a cube. We're gonna make two loop cuts here and two loop cuts, three loop cuts here and then four loop cuts here. No, five. So we're gonna take this and we're gonna move it up and then this and move it up. And then we're gonna take this and this. And these are gonna be our eyes. Right, then we're gonna take another loop cut here and then we're gonna select these three and we're gonna press like this and we're gonna press alt v g z down, hold it, then we're gonna select this and this faces e g y oh nice oh well, e then g and y back. Oh my god, we're getting a face. Like, I don't do that. It's ridiculous. Like, you can't make every model like that, basically. Because first of all, models are all different. They have all different shapes, all different proportions, right? And if you want to be a good 3D modeler and not just be a good chibi 3D modeler, for example, right? You have to be a lot more fluid in how you do things, right? So you can't watch shit like this that tells you how to do things only in a certain fucking way, right? You have to learn how to do things more fluidly, right? Like, as you go, you figure out how to do different parts. I like this guy. Oh, yeah. You can put it on your head. There. Like, I'm pretty sure I've seen tutorials like this. I could swear. I personally don't like them. Maybe they're good for some people to get some sort of results. And it's probably good, like, if you're a beginner, like I said. But when you're going down the line, you wanna... Again, you want to be able to be a lot more fluid in your modeling and not be confined only by a certain way of doing things, basically.
Where would I start?
Because the problem is, like, you're still thinking in a simple manner where you're like, show me something that I can follow. And I can understand that, because when you don't know anything, obviously you would just want to see just a way of somebody doing something. I don't know. Check different types of modelers. Like, I don't know, check Reinhardt, check... I don't know who else is doing YouTube videos like that. Literally just like go on YouTube and Google like 3D model anime head modeling and see like what other people do it, how they do it. How can you learn top of flow? Watch other people do it. If that's not an option, buy other models and then see how they're done. Like, there's multiple ways of you can like, if you don't understand how to do a top of flow, literally just buy a model. Go on Booth. There are models as cheap as like $30. They're like relatively good models. Buy them and then study it. Like, study how the how all the shapes are made, basically. Oh, here's another one. Like, you can I do have a base, basically, that I have on Booth, and I have it on Gumroad. It's $20. It comes with finished, like, all stuff applied to it, and it comes with like mirror and subdivide not being applied to it, so you can see like how all of those things are done, for example. Now, obviously it costs money, and I'm sorry that I can't just give it to you for free. I would still recommend you probably buying like a proper model. There are like a bunch of good models on Booth for a relatively cheap amount of money. Let me look at my video, dude. Like, there's this one too. Are you watching this one, the old one, or are you watching the newer one? Dude, I even like talk through this when I say like, oh, I do this, I do that. So at this point, for example, for me, I already understand what I have to do. So I have this nose and mouth. So I understand that I have to make like cheeks to be like a little bit pointing outwards right here. Like, I have it sort of imagined it already. And then I use some sculpting tool to make it like a little bit more fuller. So yeah, thank you guys very much for hanging out with me today. Links in the chat. There's Discord, Twitter, YouTube, Patreon, Booth, Gumroad. Check them out. Discord is our community. You can join us up. You can... we have art channel there. We have Blender help channel. Follow me on Twitter, YouTube, time lapses. Check them out. Patreon, just a good alternative way of supporting me. Booth, Gumroad. Check them out as well. You can buy some of my models there. But yeah, that's about it.
Apparently, if you say the word subscribe, the YouTube app's subscribe button lights up with a nice rainbow to tell you to subscribe.